would B response to the multiple universe theory, it's multiverse, being a possible explanation for the pre-existing order that leads to future orders? If this could be a possible explanation of the cause of our universe's existence, we still have yet to explain where this set of universes and its order arose. So with the consideration of infinite universes, could this infinity in any way compare to the infinitude of God?
Okay, so there's several questions there. So, and in a sense, you answer the question, questioner answered some of his own questions. But I'll say this. So first of all, the multiverse idea comes in many forms. Most of the versions of the multiverse idea that we're physicists would study are not based on there being multiple universes that have nothing to do with each other and have completely different laws and they have no relationship to each other. Most multiverse scenarios are based on the idea that there's actually a single universe, but that single universe has a sort of a multiplicity to it in its different regions of the universe. It looks like conditions can be very different in different parts of the universe, so different that at first glance, it may look like they have different laws. So you might find in a very remote part of our universe beyond what telescopes can see, you might find that there are different particles. You don't have electrons and protons or quarks and so on. You have different particles and not electromagnetism, strong and weak force, but maybe different forces. But most people in my field, most particle physicists believe that deep down, there's a set of fundamental laws that govern the whole universe, whether it's a multiverse or not. So that's one thing. Now, you could toy with the idea, and more philosophers do this than physicists. Suppose you just had an infinite number of universes or a very large number that had nothing whatsoever to do with each other. Each had its own set of fundamental laws. And so somehow all possible, and some of them might not have any laws. Some of them might be just totally haphazard. And so all possibilities are tried out, or so many are tried out that there's going to be one universe out of the zillions that happens to have laws that we observe that are make it possible to have this nice orderly universe with life in it and so forth. But that raises the question that the questioner asked, how do you account? Actually, that sort of exacerbates the problem, because now you need not just a giver of order for one universe. You have to explain why there are all the different universes and that they have these laws and not other laws, unless you say all possible things exist, which leads to other problems. But you have to explain not just one universe, you have to explain the order and the different order in different universes. I don't think that really satisfactorily accounts for anything.
Yeah.